best appliances, brands you want, expertise you need.
Hey, Andrea Hallwagner is here, and we're all super excited about this dip because you've got edamame beans in your guac dip over here.
Absolutely.
As we talk about easy and healthy appies for the season. Okay, let's dig right into that.
Dig right into this. Okay, and this works great for school lunches because it builds some protein from the soy edamame beans, and you just blend it in the food processor and toss it into your guacamole, and it works fantastic as a seasonal appetizer. What I've done here with the tortilla wraps is just brush them with a little bit of oil, a little bit of salt, pop them into the oven, and get them baked so they're nice crispy like a chip, and it looks kind
of
cool.
Oh, so you made these out of
a wrap. That's it.
What flavor are these ones?
Sun-dried tomato.
The sun-dried tomato. Mm-hmm. Okay, so it's flat. You put a little oil, a little salt. You pop it into an oven, and then it crisps up?
Exactly. You cut them with scissors, easy peasy, and they're great for the holidays. And like I said, great for your kids' lunch the next day as well.
Okay, I am the one person in the world that's not a big avocado fan. Do you think I could just do edamame dip?
You could. You'd need something to bind it. So you could take these and then, I don't know, like a hummus or a creamy or other, blend it in, and there you go.
Oh, okay, now I'm even more interested in it. That's fantastic. I was at a little buffet on the weekend, and they had these because these are just the cutest and most delicious little appetizer.
And a really simple thing to do. You can get your kids to thread them as well. If you're planning a holiday appetizer theme and you need something super speedy, at this time of year, as much as I love like the Cooking Network and the like crazy foodie stuff, most of us do not have time for fancy things that require long ingredient lists. So my goal of today's segment was really like, what can you put together that's really simple, healthy, colorful, builds in a little bit of nutrition into the season of indulgent eating?
And, well, that's the thing. Okay, so let's talk about indulging. And it's a lovely, your trees are attacking. When trees attack on the morning show, your lovely Christmas tree with broccolis. But Andrea, help me with my mind process when I'm looking at the tree of broccoli and then beside it is some sort of baked cheesy goodness that you just want to put on French bread and devour.
But the key is you're not going to not eat that, because that's the fun stuff that goes along with the holidays. You're going to take your plate, you're going to go on the seafood diet. What you see is what you're going to eat. So first of all, on your plate, you're going to load up on something vegetable oriented. Hopefully there's something there. If you're in charge of bringing something to a holiday party, make it something vegetable oriented so you at least know a little bit get on your plate. And then still take a look at everything that's there at the holiday parties and see like what's unique, what's really cool, what's really like my favorite things. Have a bit of those and then maybe skip some of the stuff that's just potato chips any time of the year. Skip those and go for the cheese bread thing that you just talked about.
and this is going to fill you up a little bit, so that if you can do your first course having some veggies and some dip and then just give it a few minutes, you're not going to be, when you go back to the buffet, like, I need the bread, the cheese, the chocolate right now.
Well, the other key thing that happens at holiday parties is people are mindlessly eating and chatting right by the table. So rather than do that, get a plate, put everything on it, because it helps to at least not be just, it helps you to keep track as to sort of how much and what you're actually eating.
So take the plate away from the buffet table, back away from the buffet table. Focus on eating your plate as you are chatting and make sure there's some vegetable. That's a really super cute tree. And
so
with your radishes, right?
So simple.
What have you done? Oh, okay.
These trees are causing us trouble, Leslie.
Yeah. What have you done with your little tiny potatoes there? Because that looks super cute.
So again, if you're making potatoes for dinner, boil them or roast them. All you need to do is literally cut them in half and then cut just a tiny little bit off the bottom so they sit flat. You can brush them with a little bit of butter, and then I just put sour cream and some green onion. You could do chives or a tiny little piece
really
of bacon.
Cute.
And it's just a nice little finger food. And again, you're going to cook dinner, so you might as well cook extra because you got people coming over the next day, and it helps to build that appetizer theme ready to go.
And is this that jelly that
Like hot pepper
red chili
jelly.
Yeah,
you can get
that's
red
delicious.
Or green, which is kind of fun seasonally. I always have this in my house. If anyone like happens to stop over and I need a super fast appetizer to throw out on the table, and it's just simply a whipped cream cheese, your favorite cracker. I love the Leslie Stowe, such a seedy kind of cracker.
Oh, yeah, those are
delicious.
Yeah, the rainforest crackers are amazing.
Really simple, really easy, and nice and colorful. You could do some red, some green, and add some fun color into the mix.
The whipped cream cheese is a delight unto itself.
Well, and it's easier to spread. That's the other thing.
If you've not tried the whipped cream cheese, do try that. Try going down that road. And then these ones have a little basil in, a little bit of the bocconcini and a tomato. It drizzle a little bit of
The balsamic
crema.
Yes.
The balsamic crema.
Delicious.
On it, and those are just delicious. Okay, great ideas.
But I have 13 ideas.
On your website.
On my website, if you want to go and
find out
more. So
there's more info from Andrea at healthstandnutrition.ca.
.com.
She's got a bunch of easy holiday entertaining ideas for you. Looks delicious. I'll try to remember the Christmas tree of broccoli.
Or if it's a kid's birthday party, it's like a snake. So you just kind of make it into cool themes.
You're fun. You're a fun mom. Way to go, Andrea. Coming up after the break, Dallas has got your news headlines. Stay with us.